Hello everyone, and welcome to our Tech Tuesday Tutorials number 131. Today, as you can guess, is May the 4th, otherwise known as Star Wars Day, and we're taking a look at some fun educational resources related to Star Wars. The first thing you may have noticed is that we had a strange opening crawl there. Well, you can get that using Star Wars Crawl Creator, which is actually at starwars.com. We'll provide the link in the description. When you come here, just click on the little editor button at the top. It'll interrupt the video, and then you can type in the title, a subtitle, and the body of the text that you'd like to see. And when you're ready, just hit done, and it'll start playing, and you can pause it or reload it or even full screen it. Still a nice little way to open up the day. The next thing I want to mention was a makerspace project idea here, and it's how to make a little lightsaber, paper lightsaber, using paper circuits. And it's pretty awesome. They give you the steps all the way through from beginning to end on how to print this out, and then where to glue your paper circuits. Materials you're going to need here, cell phone battery, straw, X-Acto knife, things like that, and where to put the copper tape and everything else. They walk you through step by step on how to create that, and even how to create the lightsaber effect using a colored straw and then bending it onto the paper and taping it down and being able to turn on your little light circuit there. So the kids should like that if you've got a decent little makerspace with a little bit of copper tape and LEDs. You're good to go. If you're into more coding, then you may want to take a look at Star Wars Building a Galaxy with Code here. It's part of the Hour of Code. There's an intro video here where Kathleen Kennedy and one of the lead programmers goes through and teaches you some of what they're going to be doing here with a basic little web app that helps you learn to code using blocks and then eventually JavaScript. Great thing is here, they have a ton of materials here in terms of the lesson itself, help videos all the way through there, vocabulary, what to do before and afterwards. And basically this is a self-contained lesson within about an hour where the kids actually get in there and do some basic coding, trying to make BB-8 actually pick up some things and stuff like that. So you just drag and drop items, they walk you through this, and then you run the code and see how that works. You don't need anything complicated, you just need a basic browser or a mobile device to get this done. Now, if you're looking for something to spend some of your budget on and you'd actually like to do some coding on the regular and entertain your kids, you may want to consider spending some of your tech budget on an original BB-8 Sphero. Now, Sphero is a company that makes all sorts of programmable little droids. Their most common ones are here, the little Sphero minis. But they do have a whole line of Star Wars themed robots. And they're basically like the Sphero with a little extra bells and whistles here. But the Sphero is what makes them so great is that they are programmable by an Android app that you run on your phone. And you can then run code and program them to do all sorts of stuff or just drive them entirely. Now, if you're into more of the dark side of things, you may want to check out the BB-9E droid, the Imperial droid, at a similar price. Now, if you're into VR,
you would become my apprentice?
Then you may want to check out Vader Immortal. They've got three series now. They're on episode 3. Each of these are kind of self-contained experiences that provide you with some actual good VR immersion here. And you actually get to wield lightsabers, deflect incoming laser shots, use the force and stuff like that. If you haven't messed around with VR stuff, you absolutely need to. It's incredible and it's very immersive. And if you're not into this, then maybe you might be into Beat Saber. So Beat Saber is a game where you have to hit the blocks as they come at you while you're wielding these like lightsabers in VR, and they can come at you pretty fast, or you can of course scale it down to difficulty, but included it in this today because it's basically lightsabers to the beat, right? And of course when you're actually in the environment, you don't see yourself, you just see this, but it's pretty intense. Now, if you just rather mess around with 3D models and objects, you can do that as well. First, SketchUp has a ton of things that you can find on there. If you just search for, let's say, Star Wars or TIE Fighter or so on, and if you just go over here to the models category, you can find all sorts of stuff that users have created based on Star Wars. Some of my favorites here is this model of an actual TIE Fighter, and it's just incredibly detailed. And zoom in, zoom out, and see the full detail of the ship. Here's an AT-AT walker. Again, in full 3D, you can pan around in every angle. And this is using SketchUp. But the model files are online. You just download them and open them up. Now, if you are really into 3D, you might want to look at 3D printing. In which case, Thingiverse, which is a website that houses all sorts of 3D models for printing, has tons of stuff related to Star Wars, including this little Baby Yoda figure, Han Solo's blaster, and of course BB-8. But yeah, you can download these files and print them out on your 3D printer and have your own little objects there. Some of them require some assembly and some glue, but other ones are actual self-contained one-piece objects. So if you got a 3D printer in your media center, this is a great, great thing to do on May the 4th or for the whole week. Now, there's a channel on YouTube called Corridor Crew, and these are visual effects artists that do just amazing stuff. Really great if your kids are into STEM or just looking into graphical effects and so on. Well, they did a video comparing the size of ships in Star Wars to real-world environments. Of course, they applied their own talents at visual effects to actually place things here in moving video and just show you just the scale of some of these things. Some of these things are just impressive in terms of size, and you never really realize just how big Star Destroyers are, where the Death Star is, or anything else like that in relation to actual real-world objects. Now, if you're more interested in just the scale and size, and you're talking about that in relation to things, then you may want to take a look at this video here, Real Scale in 3D, by a channel called Metal Ball Studios. And they do all sorts of size comparison and scale comparison videos, which really give you an idea of how big some of these things are, or how massive certain concepts are. But this is just incredible when you really start looking at the size and scale of certain things like the Death Star and so on. They don't just do objects, sometimes they do concepts. So in this case, we're looking at total deaths by a pandemic in perspective in a visual. So the SARS, the MERS, both of which were coronavirus type viruses, to Ebola. And you think that's pretty bad, and you start really looking at just how much each of these amounted to. And even as these rise and you see these big numbers like 12 million dying, none of them really quite compare, not even HIV and AIDS compared to the big one, the granddaddy of them all, and that's the Black Death at 200 million. But sometimes, you know, when you start talking about big numbers, it's really hard to visualize it. And this channel does a pretty good job of that. So if you just want something funny to kind of take us out here, you like Star Wars, you like some humor, you want something to show your kids that's safe for school, you may want to take a look at Seagull Stop It Now, Bad Lip Reading for Empire Strikes Back. It's a catchy little song in it. My daughter loves the song. We sing this all the time. Anyways, links to all of this stuff are going to be in the video description, and we hope you guys had a good time with this.
Listen, man, I'm not your friend.
Don't fall asleep.
So I hope you all enjoyed this video and hope you found it useful. And if you did, go ahead and click that like button. Heck, why not support us and click that subscribe button. Click the bell icon to receive email notifications. Leave a comment or idea for a Tech Tuesday video below. Share this video with your friends, and we'll see you in the next video. Bye-bye.